अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। वंस अगेन आई वेलकम यू टू द ऑनलाइन अरबिक क्लास। डियर इंटरमीडिएट सेकेंड ईयर स्टूडेंट्स, वी वर डीलिंग विद द टॉपिक अल मुरक्कब अत तौसीफी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टेक अ शॉर्ट रिकैप ऑफ द प्रीवियस क्लास, then we will proceed toward the exercises. Exercise number 1, uktub al juz'ain min al murakkab at tawsifi bil amthilati, write the two parts of adjective phrase with examples. This exercise we will do. So first we will take a review of the previous class. What is the review? What is the meaning of al murakkab at tawsifi? This is a lesson of section grammar. Then this is a lesson of section grammar, lesson number 2. Okay, this is the lesson number 2, namely al murakkab at tawsifi. And other name for al murakkab at tawsifi is al murakkab al wasfi. Okay, one more name is there for this phrase. What is that? That is annat wal man'ut. Annatu wal man'utu. Okay, descriptive phrase. In English, it is called as adjectival compound and adjective phrase as well as descriptive phrase. Okay, these three names are there for this phrase. In English, adjectival phrase, adjectival compound or descriptive phrase. Three names. And in Arabic, al murakkab at tawsifi, al murakkab al wasfi, annatu wal man'utu. These three names are there for the same topic. Okay, for the same phrase. In Arabic we have three names and in English we have three names, but the topic is the same itself. Okay, what is the meaning of al murakkab? Al murakkab means compound. What is compound? Compound means two or more words joined together called as a compound. Okay, two or more words joined together and form a word, form a phrase or a sentence called as a compound. Compound can be a sentence, compound can be a phrase. Phrase contains few words, whereas a sentence, phrase gives a meaning but not complete, whereas sentence gives a complete meaning. This is the difference between the phrase and sentence. So here we are talking about al murakkab al tawsifi, adjective phrase. We are talking about the phrase. Okay, in this phrase there are two nouns. This phrase contains two nouns. Okay, in Arabic we have broader concept of noun. Okay, in Arabic we have broader concept of noun. In Arabic, we can describe the words as al-ismu, al-failu, and al-harfu. In the whole Quran, we have these three parts of the, these three words. In the whole Quran, we cannot find other than these three words. Either we find al-ismu, or we find al-failu, or we find al-harfu. Okay. There is no other word other than these three words in the whole Quran. So ism can be definite or indefinite, whatever may be, but all the nouns comes under this category. In ism category, this covers, Arabic ism covers four categories of English. For example, noun is covered by ism, pronoun is covered by ism, and adjective is covered by ism, and adverb is also covered by al-ism. Got it? These four types comes under the category al-ism only in Arabic. Okay, and al-fail, failun or al-fail covers all the verbs. Al-fail covers all the verb forms, past, present, future, imperative, negative imperative, imperfect tense, simple present tense, simple past tense, simple future tense, or past perfect continuous, present perfect continuous, whatever the types are there, all the types is covered by al-fail verbs. And harf has a broader concept in Arabic. This covers prepositions. This covers prepositions, and this covers interrogatives, and this also covers conjunctions, and interjections, etc. So, in Arabic, these three parts is the type of what? These three parts are the type of al-kalimatu. Okay, which you have come across in first year classes. Al-kalimatu can be of three types: al-ismu, al-failu, al-harfu. Ism covers noun, pronoun, adjective, and adverb. Fail covers all the verbs. Harf covers prepositions, interrogative words, conjunctions, and interjections. Okay, this concept we have in Arabic. Got it. Now, so what I am talking about here, I am talking about the noun. Basically, al-murakkab at-tawsifi is a noun phrase. We are talking about the al-murakkab at-tawsifi. Al-murakkab at-tawsifi is a noun phrase. It contains two nouns. Okay. Now you may have a question in your mind that how can the adjective come into the category of a noun? Since childhood we are learning about the adjective is different from noun. But in Arabic it is not like that. In Arabic, noun covers adjective, noun covers adverb, noun covers pronoun, noun covers nouns, ism. Ism covers all these four categories in Arabic. Ism is a very broad concept in Arabic. So adjective also comes under the category of noun. That is the reason we are saying here as adjective phrase contains two nouns. Al-murakkab at-tawsifi contains two nouns. The first noun, the first noun is called as al-mawsuf, means described noun, and the second noun is called as as-sifatu, describing noun. Okay. Here, the second noun describes the first one. For example, we have, now look at the board. You can see here that bintun, girl. Bintun. Okay, this is a noun, a girl. Bintun, it is a noun, girl. Here, dhakiyatun, intelligent. Okay, if we translate this as a girl intelligent, it is translated as, linguistically it is translated as girl intelligent, but actually in English we translate this as an intelligent girl. And intelligent, an intelligent girl. Okay, ek hoshiyar ladki. To ab yahan par an intelligent girl, bintun dhakiyatun. So here bintun is called as, in grammatical conditions, in grammatical terms, in grammatical analysis, in grammatical analysis, bintun is called as al-mausuf. Okay. Whereas zakiyatun is called as as-sifatu. Are you following? Al-mausufu, as-sifatu. Okay. Al Mausuf, what we call Mausuf? Described noun. Described noun. Keep in your minds, this is very important. I am going to give this topic in your coming exam on Sunday. On Sunday's exam, you have to do the grammatical analysis of adjective phrase in this way only. So try to concentrate how to give grammatical analysis, how to do grammatical analysis. Bintun, Dakiyatun will be given. You have to underline Bintun, then give a arrow mark, then write it Al-Mausufu, then write it Described Noun. Dakiyatun As-Sifatu, it is known as Describing Noun. Describing Noun. Okay, both the nouns together known as Al-Murakkab At-Tawsifi. Al-Murakkab At-Tawsifi, adjective phrase. Both the nouns together known as adjective phrase. Now, here, these two nouns, the adjective describing noun must correspond, tally with, must follow Al-Mausufu. As-Sifatu must follow Al-Mausufu in four cases. Four cases, what are those four cases? Number one is Al-Jinsu. Number one is Al-Jinsu. Al-Jinsu. Jinsu means gender. Okay. Number one is Al-Jinsu. Jinsu means gender. So, Al-Mausuf here, As-Sifatu must follow Mausuf in gender. If the Mausuf is female gender, then the Sifat must be female gender. Here, Bintun belongs to a word. Bintun is a word which belongs to a girl. So it is feminine gender. Similarly, Dakiyatun is a feminine noun. Why we are adding Golta here, Raunta, Taun, Mudavviratun? Because it is a female sifa, female noun, Dakiyatun. Bintun, Dakiyatun. Bintun is Mausuf, Dakiyatun is Sifat. So it must follow, Sifat must follow Mausuf in gender. If Mausuf is female gender, then Sifat must be female gender. If Mausuf is male gender, then Sifat must be male gender. Got it? Remember this point. You have to write these points in the exam. Okay. Second, the Sifatun must follow Mausuf in number. Al-Adadu. Number. Numbers are three in Arabic. Singular, dual and plural. So, if Al-Mausuf is singular, then As-Sifatu must be singular. If Al-Mausuf is dual, then As-Sifatu must be dual. And if Al-Mausuf is plural, then Sifatu must be plural. Got it? So, the Sifat must follow Mausuf in Adad as well. In gender, in number, and in number three, and in state. Okay. And in state. At-Tadkiru, At-Tankiru, Wat-Tarif. At-Tarif, Wat-Tankir. Tarif, Wat-Tankir. A tarif a tankin means state. State or definite state. Definite state or indefinite state. Okay. A tarif a tanki, definiteness or indefiniteness. A sifatu must be must follow al mausuf in definiteness and indefiniteness. If the mausuf is indefinite noun, then sifat must be indefinite noun. Like we have two dhammas over here, and here also two dhammas are there. This is the indication and sign of indefinite noun. So a sifatu is following the mausuf in indefiniteness. A sifatu is following al mausuf. Okay. Similarly, in fourth case, case ending. Al halatu. Case ending. Cases can be nominative, accusative, or genitive. Okay. Cases can be nominative, accusative, or genitive. Al halatu. Fourth one is al halatu. So, as-sifatu must follow al-mausuf in cases. If mausuf is in nominative case, then the sifat must also be in nominative case. If the mausuf is in accusative case, the sifat will also be in accusative case. If the mausuf is in genitive case, then the sifat must follow the mausuf in genitive case. For example, this is in nominative position. Bintun dakiyatu. The example of accusative case is bintan dakiyatan. Bintan zakiyatan. So here you see, when we take two fathas over ta, then we add two fathas over the round ta as well, because it follows the mausuf. Bintan dakiyatan. A change in the case does not bring any change in the meaning. The change in the case does not bring any change in the meaning. For instance, if a person changes the clothes, the person cannot change by changing the clothes. So these vowels are the signs of they are describing the case. Okay, these are equal to close. For understanding, I am saying these are equal to close. The changing of clothes does not bring any change in the person. So bintan is mausuf, dakiyatan is asifatu. Last one, if this is in accusative case, bintin zakiyatin. This is accusative. This is genitive case. Two kasras are the indication of genitive case. Bintin dakiyatin. Here also, a change in the case does not bring any change in the meaning. The meaning will be an intelligent girl. Why we are using an here? An we are using because we cannot use a before a vowel, before a vowel sound in English. That is a rule of English. The an we are using here, an intelligent girl. Instead of saying a intelligent girl, we are using an, because the rule of English says before a vowel sound we use an. Similarly, if we prefix al bintu, then we must put al to the sifat as well, al dakiyatu. Okay, this is al mausuf, this is as sifat. Okay, so al is there in mausuf, so sifat must follow the mausuf. It must have al in the beginning. Similarly, if the mausuf is dual, then the sifat will also be dual. If the mausuf is plural, then sifat will also be plural. Now, you may take the screenshot of this, then I shall rub the board. Take the screenshot, a snapshot. For understanding purpose, take the screenshot. In the next exam on Sunday, I am going to give the question, define al-murakkab at-tawsifi Okay, means write the definition of al murakkab at tawsifi. This I will give. And in second question, I shall give adjective phrases and ask you to do grammatical analysis. How to do grammatical analysis? In this way, as I have done here for you. Bintun zakiyatun. Bintun is al mausufu and zakiyatun is asifatu. Together known as al murakkab at tawsifi. Got it? Shall I rub the board? Shall we proceed? Okay. Now we are proceeding towards our exercise. This is the explanation of the lesson. Then I am doing the exercise for you on the board, which I will ask you in the coming exam on Sunday. What is the exercise? The exercise is Uktub. First exercise we are solving on the board of lesson number 2 from section Grammar Al Murakkab at Tawsifi, exercise 1. Exercise 1 is asking Uktub. Here he is asking Uktub, write Al Juz'ain. Al Juz'ain. Al Juz'ain means two parts. Uktub Al Juz'ain, write the two parts. Min al murakkab at tawsifi. Okay, write the two parts of possessive phrase. Write the two parts of possessive phrase. Bil amsilati, with examples. Bil amsilati, with examples. Write the two parts of possessive phrase with examples. This is the question. Okay. I will write the translation as well. Write the two parts of adjective phrase with examples. Got it? Answer. How we will write the answer for this? Okay, this answer we have to write. He is asking you to write two parts. So first we will copy Al Murakkab at Tawsifi as it is in the answer. Al Murakkab at Tawsifi. We will write Al Murakkab at Tawsifi as it is in the answer. Al Murakkab at Tawsifi. As it is, we will take it down as it is. Al Murakkab at Tawsifi, same as the question. Okay. Now we will take part number 1. What is the part 1 of Al Murakkab at Tawsifi? Part 1 is Al Mausuf. Part 1 is Al Mausuf. What is the second part? Second part is As-Sifatu. These are the two parts. So half of the question is answered. Half of the question is answered. Uktub al-juz'ain min al-murakkab at-tawsifi bil-amthilati. Write the two parts of adjective phrase with examples. So first, the first part is, he is asking us to write two parts of the possessive adjective phrase. Second part of the question is bil-amthila with examples. So we have completed the first part. Okay, we took Al Murakkab at Tawsifi as it is given in the question. The first part we will write Al Mausuf and the second part is As-Sifatu. Okay. Then the second part of the question is Bil Amsilati. Bil Amsilati, instead of Bil Amsilati, we will write Al Amsilatu. Okay. Al Amsilatu means examples. So we will give 3 examples for it. Okay, we will give example number 1 as we taken waladun or waladun zakiyun. Waladun zakiyun. An intelligent boy. Just now we took the example of bintun zakiyatun, an intelligent girl. Now we are taking the example of waladun zakiyun, intelligent boy. Okay, intelligent boy. Second one. Now, if possible, how to do the grammatical analysis for it? The grammatical analysis is, we have to underline al-waladu, waladun, and we have to write al-mausuf. We have to underline zakiyun, then we have to write as-sifatu. Both the nouns together known as al-murakkab at-tawsifi. Are you following? Okay. Both the nouns together known as al-murakkab at-tawsifi. Jawahar, yes, I will answer your query in a few moments. Try to understand what I am writing on the board. Got it? Right. Remaining examples. Second example number two. Waladun zakiyun. Baitun qadimun. Old house. Baitun qadimun. Old house. And kitabun jadidun. New book. Okay, we will stop here. We will start the doubt clarification session. Okay. Try to understand this and take the screenshot of it, because I am going to give this question in your coming weekend exam. Got it? Now we are closing our class. We will start doubt clarification session. Okay. Thank you.